You're here for the right time, because how much therapy do you think it would take to cure anxiety or break a bad habit like smoking or biting your nails? Well, hypnotherapist Mark Stevens says you can do it in as little as 3 minutes, and you can do it yourself.
Really?
It's pretty good, isn't it?
It's better if you can do it yourself.
Well,
isn't
hey,
it?
Don't take my word for it. Take his.
Oh, I was.
He's right here to join us now to explain. Hello, Mark.
Great to be here,
Hello.
Tristan and Jess. Well, the thing is, we're all in some type of a trance anyway. We get stuck in the chocolate trance or the I'm not good enough trance or the I'll do it later trance. So we're hypnotising ourselves with I'll do it next week, next month, next year, I'll start Monday, someday, one day. And self-hypnosis, it helps us flip that switch in our mind of negative thinking. So we start to tell ourselves, I can, I'll do it now, do it now, do it now, I'll get it started, get into it, get it done. And it becomes auto-suggestion where we're hypnotising ourselves, then we begin to feel differently, then we begin to behave, react and act differently.
Well, wow. So when we see that and we decide, right, this might be for me then, to suggest then that you can do it in as little as 60 seconds, I think that's the hard part of it.
I've seen people with anxiety and they're in the middle of a full-blown anxiety attack in 60 seconds to 2 or 3 minutes, and they're going, I can't believe how good I feel. The anxiety's gone, and their breathing come because they change their state. Their attention is now on something else.
How long does it take? So we practice this mantra every day. How many days does it take till we see results?
Well, change happens in an instant.
Really?
So some people might need reinforcing, so they might need to repeat those positive suggestions or hear them every day to really let that message sink in. But when you make a decision, change is instant, just like that.
Because you've tried. You've tried the old-fashioned techniques, like you beat yourself up and you're like, just do it,
yeah.
You know? And then
you almost have to convince yourself the things that you're saying.
And that's willpower. So sometimes with willpower, it's like taking a battering ram to the Great Wall of China, and we try again and again, whether it's dieting, whether it's on procrastination or whatever it might be, when we start to harness the power of our own mind and we combine that with mindfulness or meditation, all of a sudden, it's a different reality. So you're thinking and feeling a different way.
Wow. Does it work with self-love?
Yeah. You know, absolutely. So many people, we walk around going, I'm not good enough, I don't deserve it. When we start to say, I matter, I'm worthwhile, I am good enough, I do deserve it, that becomes self-hypnosis. Then we start to feel the feelings that go with those thoughts.
I'm in. I'm in. And I want to. Can we do a demo?
Absolutely, we can do a demonstration.
Yeah.
So, Jess, what would you like to work on?
I think I would be a better mother, partner, and less divorced if I was less messier.
Less messy. Okay, so less messy. What if we came up with a little mantra or affirmation? Less mess, more organised. And less mess means less stress. Less mess, more organised. Because mess is unconscious stress.
Right.
And Tristan, have you got something you want to work on?
I'm pretty stressed.
I do. I'm going to make the most of this one now, actually, because I actually suffer with kind of like anxiety of some sort, like confidence issues. And I think it's more down to the fact that I'm in a position right now where I have to exude confidence. But to be honest with you, it eats me inside an awful lot, and I'm always kind of second-guessing myself. I find it hard to enjoy moments because I'm worried about them.
Yeah, you're not the only one, because we can all do with more confidence, we can all do with more self-esteem, feeling better about ourselves, and it still comes back to what we're thinking. If we're telling ourselves some negative thoughts, we start to feel a bit negative and then we start to react negatively. So I think for something like confidence, maybe calm, control, confident.
Okay.
I am calm, in control, and confident. And you start to breathe that, and then all of a sudden you feel centered, more calm, in control. And you're not worrying about what was making you anxious. You're focused on being calm and in control.
All right, let's get it underway. And for anyone at home who's not feeling good today, if Tristan MacManus can feel insecure and not that great, the most good-looking and talented man in Australia, it can happen to all of us. So.
And I think it's something that we should all kind of try. Do you need to be on your own somewhere? Do you need to be in a room?
You can be on your own.
You
can meditate anywhere, anytime. You can meditate while you're walking. I walk along and do a breathing meditation where I breathe in, out. I am strong. I am stronger. I am calm. Okay. Or do it now. So we can do it walking. We can do it while we're drinking water. only goodness enters my body. Eating an apple, only goodness. But it's about that positive reinforcing. So are you guys ready to do this?
Yeah.
Right,
and so can people do it at home that want to do the same thing so they get a free session from you?
Why not?
Okay, all right, get on the,
so,
get on the couch.
Sitting
get on
comfortably,
the couch.
If it's okay to sit with your feet flat water. On the ground or stay like that, however you're comfortable. Oh. And now we're going to start with a 30-second or so mini meditation to get you into a calm state. So go ahead and close your eyes all the way down. With your eyes closed all the way down, I want you to forget about everything else as you listen to the sound of my voice. Nothing else exists except the sound of my voice and your own breathing. Feel your breathing flowing in and flowing out. Really tune into the feeling of the breath falling in and falling out of your body. And as you breathe in, think the thought, peace. As you breathe out, release. Breathing in, peace. Breathing out, release. And you become more and more relaxed as you continue to think, peace, release. And any suggestions you hear that you feel are right for you, you can take them on board at the deepest level and you can repeat those positive suggestions, and that's when it becomes self-hypnosis. And Jess, and all of us can be more organised, and I'd like you to picture some mess that you've been wanting to clean up. Visualise that in your mind's eye as you think to yourself, less mess, more organised. You breathe in, less mess, more organised. And now imagine or visualise yourself getting things done. You see yourself taking action. You do it now, you take action, and you see yourself now completing that, tidying up, organising that mess, and you feel so much better. You think, I did it, and it was easy. You visualise the final moment of success as you breathe in, less mess, more organised. And now we can all feel more confident, feel calmer and more in control. So breathing in, Tristan, and all of us can do this, breathing in, calm. Breathing out, control. Breathing in, I am calm. Breathing out, control. Breathing in, calm, control. Breathing out, confidence. And now visualise yourself doing something you want to feel more confident doing, and see yourself really in a controlled state, really strong and in control, calm and in control, and feel the good feelings of being calm and in control. And when you're ready, bring all of those thoughts back to now, that image, that blueprint for the future, bring that back to now, and slowly open your eyes back in the room. How are you feeling?
I feel quite relaxed.
I just hope you don't get a big head now you're more confident. You could turn out to be a real pain.
You can never have enough confidence. You can always have more confidence.
It's actually something I will try and do at home. I think, like I said, the main thing is just being open-minded about it.
Yeah.
The more open-minded you are, the greater the chance of success. So it can work for everyone because it's about resetting the mind each day. I like to suggest that as you wake up in the morning, when you're in that half-awake, half-asleep state, what you do is you spend 5 or 10 or 15 minutes doing positive affirmations and meditation, breathing in, peace, out, release, and you set the tone for the day.
It's brilliant.
You program yourself, and then you end the day in the same way. You release all the stress and you set yourself up for a great night's sleep.
Well, that's fantastic.
It's brilliant.
Why are you giving away these tips now? I tell you why, because I know there's a lot of people looking at this and they're kind of going, I'm afraid that you'll send me asleep and I'll wake up and I'm going to be a chicken.
Yeah.
Or whatever it is, or when you hear something, you go, that's what the fear is.
Well, that's stage show hypnosis. This is clinical hypnotherapy and self-hypnosis, which is totally different.
Yep.
It's not about people having fun at a club and having a few drinks and laughing at everyone. This is about you reprogramming your own mind for success, to flip that switch in your mind and to keep resetting every day with those positive suggestions of calm, control, confident, less mess, more organised. And you'll find yourself thinking that throughout the day. Those thoughts will start to pop up. Breathing in, calm and control, breathing out, confidence, and that's self-hypnosis.
Honestly, I love it. I'm going to do a quick mop in this studio before we come back.
No, I think it's great. I just took a moment there just to kind of, I feel honestly, a lot more relaxed now. I really appreciate it. You got this book. I can't wait to read
it. It's wonderful.
Make sure you do too. Find out more about help self-hypnosis in Mark's new book, Mind Free. It's out now. Mark, thanks so much for joining us today, and thanks for the tips and the help on that.
Great to be here. Thanks, Tristan. Thanks, Jess.
Changing lives. Well done.
That's it.